Hey guys, how are you? So in this video, I'm coming to you with a pregnancy vlog. I did one, I think, when I was 19 weeks. Right now, I'm 36 weeks. It's Sunday. I'll be 37 weeks on Tuesday. So we're getting extremely close to the date. And I just wanted to share with you, a lot of you have asked questions, have sent me beautiful wishes, and are kind of curious about my pregnancy development. So I figured I would do this one before the time is gone and she's here. So yeah, let's get started. So like I said, I'm 36 weeks, and with that comes a lot of body changes. Obviously, the whole pregnancy is all about body changes and hormonal changes and emotional changes and everything. But right now, man, the belly is growing. And that is the biggest thing for me right now. It's trying to keep up with what I need to do with having the belly. And if you've been pregnant before, you know this. If you don't, if you haven't been pregnant before, then let me tell you, it is a challenge. It's a huge thing that you're carrying. It is a lot more weight. So not only are you gaining weight, but you also have this huge amount of weight protruding off, like, you know, off of your belly. So what that means is that your center of gravity has changed. And so what that entails is you walking like a penguin, or you having to change your posture and just being tired, and your back hurts and everything. It's not thing that it's like, oh my God, I need to cry about this. No, but it is kind of annoying, and it kind of slows things down. So for example, for me, the biggest thing is rolling off of bed. Like, we neglect those little things. And getting up to go to the bathroom, obviously, as you're pregnant, you're drinking so much water and you're peeing so often, you just cannot just get up and go to the bathroom. Like, it takes like a minute or so for you to like roll off of bed. I keep telling my family, I feel like a roly-poly. Like, I feel like I'm just like rolling through my life. Getting up from a chair is a lot more complicated. You can't cross your legs. And so it's definitely different. Like, the little things, for example, when you're washing the dishes or when you're washing your hands in the bathroom, I need to kind of stand to the side because the belly is kind of protruding and it's getting in the way. Or when I open a door, I have to make sure to step away from the door. Otherwise, I'll end up hitting the belly with the door. Like, it's ridiculous. But those are the little things that happen when you have a huge belly next to you. Obviously, shaving is crazy hard right now. I think that next week I won't be able to do it anymore. I'm just gonna have to get waxed or something. So another thing, for example, right now, obviously the weight gain, I'm at 167 pounds right now. I started at 137, so I've gained 30 pounds. Ideally, you shouldn't gain more than 35 pounds. It's not something that, you know, I lose sleep over, but it's something that I do kind of think about. Yeah, so I have 5 more pounds in 2 more weeks, 3 more weeks. So it's, you know, whatever. It is what it is. But I'm kind of happy with the weight gain that I've had so far. The other thing is heartburn. I remember having heartburn with Alejandro, but I don't remember having such bad heartburn with Alejandro. It may have to do a little bit with the next thing that I wanted to talk to you about, which is cravings. I am not a person who has cravings like anxiety, like I need to have a lollipop right now. No. But I do feel myself, and I do find myself wanting things more often. So for example, for me are 2 things. One of them is sweets. If you know me at all, you know that I'm not a huge sweet person. I love my sweet sour candy. Sour candy is the best thing in the world. And I do love white chocolate, but I am a person who does not eat desserts, or, you know, sometimes every month I would get like, oh, let me eat a bag of, you know, sour candy. But that's it. Lately with the pregnancy, especially like in the last 2-3 months, I have been craving sour candy, so, or sweet in general, whether it is in pastries. And if you know me at all, you know that I'm not a pastries person. But I've definitely been going for those pastries, for that froyo, for, I mean, it's crazy. So And it is something, obviously, that is not the healthiest thing for you to have. So it's something that you need to measure a lot and all that stuff. The other thing is also a bad thing, which is soda. Again, if you know me at all, you know that I don't drink soda at all. I have never been a person who is into soda. I drink either water or juice. Sweet tea right here in the South, but that's it. Never in my life have I ever preferred soda. But now I've been loving soda. And I think more than the soda aspect of it is the gas that is in things. So, for example, what I've been doing is just getting, what is it? Sparkling water and just adding it to my juices or things like that. Or, for example, having a little bit of soda before I have my juice, just to kind of like satiate the craving that I have for like that gas thing in my mouth. But very interesting. I never had those with Alejandro, and I've noticed that they're like a little bit more strong in this pregnancy than the first one. The other thing that was interesting, scary, hard during my pregnancy was that towards the beginning of the year, I don't know if you remember, but I had kind of like an impulsive trip to Colombia. And this happened the first week of January. And Zika was kind of happening, but it was mostly in Brazil. Nobody kind of knew here in the States. You would hear it sometimes in, you know, on NPR talking about the crisis in Brazil and all that stuff. But, you know, it didn't even cross my mind and all that stuff. When I spent a week and a half in Colombia, and then when I came back, it was a huge thing. And 2 weeks later, after I came back, it definitely absolutely exploded all over the world. About everybody was talking about Zika. And I was never symptomatic. I was completely asymptomatic while I was there, while I came here. And Zika is not something that, for example, Alejandro could transfer to me. So it wasn't my concern. But, you know, like, the news started talking about it and my family would ask me about it. So it kind of brought my anxiety up. Plus, I did some research and there is some chances that you could have been exposed to the virus and being completely asymptomatic. So my doctor, I have to say, was a fail. They had no idea about it. They didn't know how to help me. They didn't know what kind of tests needed to be done and all that stuff. After going through family and, you know, people that I knew, I ended up going to the hospital. To like the regional hospital, not regional hospital, but UNC, which is in Chapel Hill and is one of the biggest hospitals here in North Carolina. I went there, they tested me. They were like, yeah, we're gonna get your results in 2 weeks. Well, I didn't get my results until like 5 weeks later. By this time, I was already like 28 weeks and my stress level kind of started rising. It wasn't anything that I was losing sleep over, just because the chances of you being asymptomatic and having been exposed to the virus are very, very limited, but they still exist. But throughout the process, they did several ultrasounds and her head was growing perfectly fine. The development was awesome. The pregnancy was going great. So there wasn't anything to let me think that I could have been exposed, but it's still something that is in the back of your mind. And the fact that I was not getting those results and I was calling the hospital every single week saying, I haven't gotten my results, I haven't gotten my results, I haven't gotten my results. It was kind of like always in the back of my mind and it is pretty stressful. Finally, 5 weeks later, they came out and I was never exposed to Zika. So that is absolutely a blessing. It just lifted a weight off my shoulders and I was like, okay, now let's just like keep going with this pregnancy. But it was scary and it was a very anxiety filled time. Again, nothing that was with me 24/7, nothing that I was losing sleep over, but it was still something that was, again, in the back of my mind. So yeah, so that was my thing with Zika. And the next thing I wanted to talk to you about was the fact that I don't know if I mentioned it in my previous vlog, but I decided to have a C-section with this pregnancy. Alejandro, my first pregnancy, ended up being a C-section. I went through my whole labor process. I pushed for 3 hours and he just didn't come out. So it ended up being a C-section and the chances that that was going to happen again were pretty high. Plus it hasn't been that long. It's only been 2 years. So the scar, you know, there could have been a very low risk, but there's still a risk of the scar kind of rupturing and bleeding and all that stuff. So anyway, we decided that it was going to be a C-section. It's going to be on the 9th of June and we're super excited. And I'm sorry, my baby is being crazy going around here. My battery's about to die, so I need to finish this. Being a C-section, it is a whole different feeling of it being in labor, and the fact that it's my second child. It just makes everything so much easier, in my opinion. Like with Alejandro, I was like, by this time, I had everything that he was ever going to need for the next 2 years. And it was very kind of, you know, anxious, you know, very anxiety filled time, making sure that I had absolutely everything that I could possibly need, even if I didn't need it. With her, not only is my second child and I kind of already know what I kind of need and don't need, but I also feel more confident about making those decisions and saying, no, we can avoid that, or no, we don't, this isn't something that we technically absolutely need. Plus a lot of things we already have from Alejandro's, you know, baby days. So that is awesome. The next thing and final thing that I wanted to talk to you about was Alejandro. A lot of you have been asking about how Alejandro's been feeling about the pregnancy, how he's been feeling about Camila. And I have to tell you, I have been very, very impressed. He has been very clingy lately, more so than before. But he is also very loving. He's been going with me to all of my appointments. He knows how Camila's heartbeat goes. He's seen her in the ultrasound several times. He knows that she's there. He talks to her. He gives her kisses. He says hi to her every morning. He knows, like, he notices when she moves and all that stuff. And he's like, he laughs hilariously, like, watching her move and just... Mommy. Every time he sees a baby, he'll go like, Pita, Pita, and then he'll point to my belly. He calls her Pita. He can't say Camila, so Pita's like his name for her. And he's just been very, oh, and like, if you ask him how Camila's gonna go, he goes like, eh, eh, like he, she's crying. So he's amazing. You can hear him in, over there. Mm-hmm. So yeah, he's doing amazing, and I'm so surprised actually that he's taking it so easily now. I cannot carry him as much. I cannot do as many things with him just because, like, because I have this huge belly. But he's been amazing, and so I think it's gonna be awesome, and he's totally gonna enjoy it. So guys, that is my pregnancy vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next one. Thank you so much for all of your wishes, for all of your questions, for all of your comments. I so appreciate them, and so does Camila, and so does Alejandro. So thank you so much, and I will see you in the next one, okay? Bye!